Hokulea's first navigator is being immortalized on a wall in Kakaako. Artist Kamea Hadar and students from 808 Urban and the Powwow School of Art spent the last week and a half painting a mural of Piu's Mau Piailug. It's at the corner of Oahe and Cook Streets, and many students didn't know who Mau was when they first started.
I learned that he was really important in the, I guess, the revival of a certain art form that was lost in the Hawaiian culture. He taught the art of celestial navigation.
My hope with this mural is not only to teach people about Master Mau and about, you know, everything that he represents, but also just, you know, to bring awareness to the worldwide voyage.
Hadar says he hopes it's a constant reminder that canoes Hokulea and Hiki Analia are out there in the world representing Hawaii for the next 3 years.
Mau Piailug was from Micronesia. He happened to be in Hawaii when the founders of the Polynesian Voyaging Society were looking for a navigator. And the rest is history, a legacy that will be carried on Hokulea Exploring Earth. Mau said, if you want to learn navigation, send your son. Mau was chosen as a baby by his grandfather to be a navigator and follow in a long tradition that goes back 3,000 years. He took Mau to the ocean. The tide pools got immersed in nature on their tiny island home called Satawal. Mau learned the star compass. He learned to build canoes and to sail, eventually graduating as a master po navigator at age 16, navigating between Micronesia's islands, thousands of miles west of Hawaii, where such traditions had long ago ended. But in 1975, Hokulea was launched, Hawaii's first long-distance deep-sea voyaging canoe in 600 years. Building it in less than 2 years was one thing. Learning to sail her and navigate her in 1 year was another. But Mau came.
Back in the mid-70s, when Hokulea needed to go to Tahiti to fulfill its destiny, we needed a navigator. In that time in the Earth, there were only six that were masters still left, none in Polynesia, only in Micronesia.
Keep in mind, Mau had never sailed south of the equator, and so he came here to the Bishop Museum Planetarium.
So the planetarium was a really important tool to bring him here, to get familiar with that sky that he's, in his whole life and his experience, he's never seen.
After a blessing at Honolulu Bay, Maui on May 1, 1976, Mau navigated a canoe much bigger than he ever sailed in Micronesia, a distance six times longer than he ever voyaged, under stars that had never guided him before. But they did, and Mau found their way.
He came and was the navigator that pulled Tahiti out of the sea, and that gave Hokulea its, both its legacy and its destiny.
2 years later, Mau returned in a second great act of compassion for Hawaii.
We needed the teacher, so Mau came back for the next three decades and trained all of us. So it's Mau's contribution are enormous. If voyaging has any value, it would not ever have been successful without those two things, being the navigator and being the teacher.
What a great man. Yeah. Mau passed away in 2010. But before he passed, a third act of compassion in 2007 and 2008, he bestowed po, basically graduating five navigators from Hawaii and five from other parts of Polynesia. He wanted to ensure traditional, non-instrument navigation continued and flourished.
And because of him, we now can pass that on to future generations. We owe him so much. Yeah.